Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we will start the 10th lecture of this your money and banking class. When we talk about function of State Bank of Pakistan, so these are the same function which is being performed by central bank of any country. Mostly we will discuss those functions which we have already discussed in the central bank chapter. When we talk about State Bank of Pakistan, the major and primary function which is being performed by State Bank of Pakistan is issuing currency note. And the State Bank has a monopoly of issuing note in Pakistan, and they have a sole authority of issuing currency note of Pakistan, that is rupees. But apart from that, they are not authorized to issue coins. The coins are issued by the government of Pakistan. And the act which is associated with and which is granting the authority to State Bank of Pakistan for issuing note is Act of 1956. And the main offices which are issuing these notes are located in Karachi, Peshawar and Lahore. The main emphasis of these offices or the issuing of these currency note through a single entity or single body is that they have a uniformity in the system. The notes are similar and they are homogeneous, and secondly they have a control over the money supply, because supply of money is an important component of an economy which can increase and which can result in inflation and many other negative consequences, or so on. Decrease in money supply can causes deflation and other monetary problems. If you have control over money supply, it can be done through issuing of currency note, which is being under the control of a central body, which is State Bank of Pakistan, and which is obviously a government-owned institute. And another important aspect of having a body which is authorized by government for a note issuing is that it will increase the public confidence, that if you had a legal backing of the government, so people can trust your currency and they can comfortably use that that form of money or that currency in their day-to-day use. The primary function which is the issuing of currency note, there are different methods of currency issue note. Widely used method is fixed fiduciary system, and it is a system which is given in 1956 to 1965. And mostly it is a new form. At that time it was a new form of currency principle, and central bank issue note fixed by government, it is being fixed by the government that this amount of notes would be issued by a state bank, and this fixed amount of note is actually backed by the government securities and bonds. And if the government wants to issue more notes, they have to put certain amount of metallic reserve, and then they can issue these notes. And that means that the additional issue would be definitely backed by a certain amount of backed by metallic reserve. The advantage of this type of issuing note system is that the government has control over inflation, and the chances of currency overissue which can create negative impact, and can create negative impact on the economy as a whole, there would be no chance of over issuing of currency notes. Another type of currency issue system is proportional reserve system, and this is the proportional reserve system is a system in which notes issue is backed by metallic reserve, and the rest of amount is backed by government bonds and securities. Almost 25 to 40% is backed by gold, 60 to 75% backed by government securities and bonds. When we talk about Pakistan, so in Pakistan 30% issues are against government reserve, and 70% are against government securities and bonds. The third type of method of note issuing is a minimum reserve system. The proportional reserve system of note issue has been replaced by minimum reserve system in Pakistan in 1965. And according to this system, the central bank has to keep only a minimum amount of reserve in a form of gold, silver, and foreign exchange securities. The central bank can expand note issue in accordance with the volume of business activities without backing of gold. The level of currency backing by gold is fixed at ₹1,200 million in Pakistan. The merit of this system is that it ensures an adequate supply of currency to meet business demands of the currency country. In other words, the method of note issuing is sufficiently elastic. The demerit is that paper currency issued is particularly inconvertible in this system. Like mostly you can say it is a fiat type of money which is being issued, because in the backing of that there is no reserves present. Then we have a control of credit. Another function of your central bank is that they control the credit system of the economy, and they control the availability or and the amount of cost of credit in the economy at any time. The main purpose is that they want to have full employment. Then not only full employment of the human resource, it also ensures the full employment of all the natural resources and other resources within the economy, and they want to stabilize the price within the economy and want to increase in the production in order to have a, in order to have a positive impact on the GDP or through with different functions or different methods can be used to control the credit within the economy. So mainly, first of all, we can say the open market operations, like increase and decrease issuing of bonds and purchase and sale of bonds, through which they can control the credit within the economy, or they can vary the bank rates, like increase and decrease the interest rate, which can increase the availability or cost of the capital within the cost of the credit available in the economy. Then credit rationing techniques, in which they can limit that how much percent or how much amount of a loan should be given to different sectors. So it will help to maintain the sufficient amount of supply of credit to different sectors of within the economy. Then varying reserve requirements, that is actually the requirement of state bank or central bank. And this is a requirement from the commercial banks, that they have to put certain amount of reserve with the State Bank of Pakistan. So when they want to tighten credit policy, so they increase their reserve requirements, and vice versa, if they want to increase the credit within the economy or circulation of credit within the economy, so they can decrease the reserve requirement. Then varying marginal requirements, when we look into the marginal requirement, it is actually the amount or proportion of the security on which the credit is given. Like for example, if you have a security which is worth 1 crore, one crore, so the government, the state bank or central bank will not provide you the 100% of that security. They will obviously provide you 70 or 80%. So the amount which is kept as a margin is a marginal requirement. Like for example, if you have you can provide 70% of the security, so 30% is a margin requirement that would be kept with the bank. Then a consumer's credit regulation, the central bank can tighten credit regulation if they want to control the credit or want to stricken the credit, decrease the credit availability. They can also use moral persuasion through different media or through different campaigns. They can persuade people to use loan, or if you want to restrict that, so they can persuade people to do not get credit or don't use frequent use of credit. Whatever the case is, it depends upon the scenario. Then direct action, if certain commercial banks or any other banks who are working under the supervision of central bank or State Bank of Pakistan. So if they are not complying with the policy or credit policy given by the government and given by the central bank, so they can take direct action and restrict them to obey the rules or policy being put by the State Bank of Pakistan. Then another function of central bank or State Bank of Pakistan is that they actually supervise and controls all the commercial banks within the economy, like for example matters related to a bank's liquidation, their reconstruction, restructuring, their performance and their valuation. All the aspect regarding these aspect of the bank would be done by the Central Bank of or State Bank of Pakistan. And they actually they supervise banks and they keep their reserves with them. They have they could also be a lender of last resort to the bank. They can also provide them facility of rediscounting, bill of exchange, and etc. And also they put regulations for the working of the different banks which are working under their supervision. Then not only that, State Bank can also provide the facility of clearing house different bank where there were representative of different bank and they meet each other and they actually exchange checks withdrawn. And the main task of State Bank is that they settle their differences among different banks, and so there would be minimum utilization of cash. Then another function of central bank is that they act as a lender of last resort to different commercial banks. Like they act as a lender of last resort for commercial bank. They use and this facility is used when bank have a shortage of cash reserve, and this, in this case the State Bank comes to their rescue and they help them, and because it's a very dangerous situation. And the main method which is used by commercial banks in order to get credit from the State Bank is that they will go and apply for rediscounting facility of bill of exchange and also their treasury bills. And this will help the commercial different banks from safeguarding from the liquidation of the banks, because they have to comply with certain reserve requirement. So in order to fulfill their requirement, they can seek help from State Bank of Pakistan. Then not only that, the State Bank can also provide bankers, agents and financial advisor facility to the government. On behalf of government, they can collect taxes and other payments, like for example they can collect taxes, they can collect all the bills or any are being collected by different banks, and these are being aggregated in the State Bank of Pakistan. Then apart from that, they can help because they are providing banker facility to the government. They can also pay debts, and the amount would be transferred from the Central Bank or State Bank of Pakistan to the other to the banks of other countries. They can also put the deposits of the government, because they are also providing bankers facility to the government. That's why they're all the deposits of the bank of the government are in State Bank. And in certain time or the time of certain need, they can also provide short-term advances to the government as well. And they can also provide, because they can serve as a custodian to foreign exchange reserve, and they see the flight of foreign exchange from the country and going off to the country, and they have the reserve of all the foreign exchange of the government. So they can provide foreign exchange for purchasing foreign goods, repaying goods, and also provide a foreign exchange facility to different government officers for their tours or for payment of their bills and etc. And another thing, they can also help them to pay external debts. Apart from different primary function, there are many secondary function which is being performed by State Bank of Pakistan, which includes for secondary function of the State Bank of Pakistan is to play a significant role of public debt management, as SBP serve as an agent of government of Pakistan for managing domestic public debt. SBP is responsible for conducting auctions of marketable government securities like MTBs, BIPs and GIS, and managing certain public debt data. SBP also regulates primary dealers for government securities. The main aim is to improve liquidity in the debt market of the government securities by improving price discovery and diversify investor base, and to channelize saving of the end investors directly to the debt instrument by bringing more efficiency in banks intermediation process. So mostly these debts are being taken by the government in order to cope with the budget deficit problem and balance of payment problems. So the main emphasis of State Bank is to have an efficient management of public debt of the government. Secondly, another important function of State Bank is that they will actually provide a significant role in the management of foreign exchange. Like State Bank is the custodian of foreign exchange reserve, and they have to manage and reserve and keep an eye on the currency inflow and outflow, and their main emphasis is to keep a certain amount of reserves and pay or arrange foreign exchange at any time the government needs. Like another function is that they fix the value of the currency. And as an agent of the government of Pakistan, they also represent different international financial institutions like IMF, World Bank, and represent Pakistan over there. Then another important function of State Bank of Pakistan is that they are advisor to the government, and they maintain deposits account and also domestic and foreign currency transaction, and they provide advice on different financial matters at the time when the government is planning for their next year budget, they are developing their fiscal policy, so they can seek important advice from the people from the State Bank of Pakistan. And the government also hold deposited account at Central Bank, and these actually accounts are being used for receiving funds, making payments and clearing checks issued by the government. Then there are different non-traditional functions which is being performed by State Bank of Pakistan, like development of financial institutions like commercial bank, microfinance and Islamic banks. Like a microfinance bank will provide finance to SMEs and cottage industry. In order to boost this kind of industry, they can establish and develop these kind of financial institution. Like this increased awareness of our religion or Islam, people are not willing to save their money in a conventional bank. So many Islamic banks are established to cope or to provide facility to those people who are who want to save their money under Islamic principle. Then they also provide training facility to different bankers in order to give them insight of the new development in the banking world within the world over or globally. And they can also develop different specialized financial institution in different area, and they can also develop certain policies which can give credit priorities to different like sector, like in industrial, agriculture and export sector, etc. Whatever the functions of State Bank of Pakistan is, the main aim of these function is that State Bank want to give economic boost to the economy. They can help in the economic growth of the country, and they can provide a crucial role in this situation, that facilitating and boosting the economic development, improving financial markets like banks, financial institutions, different mutual funds and different other organization which can provide credit facilities and other payment facilities to the people who can play an important role in the development of the economy. They can also make their contribution in the capital market improvement, like when capital market improvement by facilitating different sectors, by facilitating loan facilities to different sectors. And they also help commercial bank through supporting scheme by offering export at low rate, like they can provide loans for the loan low interest loan to those people who are indulged in exporting activities, etc. They can also establish special credit institution in order to meet medium and large term financial needs of different types of businesses. So this is the main aim of State Bank of Pakistan. Apart from that, they can also develop certain prudential regulations like code of conduct or guidelines through which State Bank can supervise the institution and show standard format for activity in order to decrease risk taking. And the main purpose of developing these regulation is to, they want to provide safety to the depositor fund, because people are investing or putting their savings into these commercial banks, and in order to provide safety and increase the confidence of these depositors, they put certain regulations. And second one is that they want to keep the financial stability, then uniformity in different sectors. So these are the prudential rules or regulations are developed in order to give in order to fulfill these aims of the central bank.